changed, as in, is he capable of having an epiphany about anything ever?
We'll take that as a no.
Well, he's a narcissist, right? I mean, look at the way he disrupted Kyle and Summer's vow renewal ceremony. It was so incredibly obnoxious. And I don't believe he had an awakening after he crashed his fancy car and then he went to an ashram. Just two exotic things he can check off his bucket list.
I imagine he's lying to himself to some extent, don't you think?
Exactly. Well, that's what chronic liars do, right? Guys like that, it's a reflex. We've learned that the hard way.
I guess we have.
He's a master manipulator. He always has been. I mean, when we were married, he was supposed to be so incredibly in love with me, and yet, well, he cheated on me, you know, twice. Anyway, he was involved in business dealings that hurt people I cared about. Now I'm supposed to believe it's just a coincidence that he shows up in Genoa City a few months after Diane did.
Wait, you think there's some connection between the two of them?
Yeah, I think there's a strong possibility.
What?
I think somehow they were involved when Diane was living in Los Angeles.
This is the first I am hearing of any of
them. Well, it stands to reason if I'm right about this, Diane would want to keep it under wraps. I mean, she's been going on and on about the exemplary life she lived in L.A., you know, how hard she worked to change things and how frugal she was. So if she did find herself once again in Tucker's orbit, I mean, how long do you think that saintly lifestyle would have lasted?
Well, what makes you think that he even knew that she was alive, let alone that they were collaborating?
It's complicated, and I don't have enough time to give you details. I'm sorry, I've got to get to work. I know, I'm leaving your writer's brain to torment. I'm really sorry, Tracy.
You've got that right.
Trust me, there are possible links between these two charlatans that are just too much of a coincidence to ignore. And I don't have any proof. Yet.